This is now fourth Shivratri in a row. Third. Third Shivratri. See, every month has a Shivratri. Today is called Maha Shivaratri because of all the Shivratris. The 14th day of the month, that is just before Amavasya. The 14th day of the month, which is just before Amavasya, is the Shivratri. That day specifically, the vibration or the potential of that day is connected to Shiva. But on Mahashivaratri, the whole energy of the planet becomes very unique. On Mahashivaratri, there is an aspect of ease, there is an aspect of being put on fast forward, being put on a really rapidly increasing clip of evolution. In yoga, we understand that there are 24 planes of existence, 24 lokas, 24 dimensions. And they are not in 24 different steps or hierarchies, they are all intertwined. They are all vibrationally different planes. So at the moment, we are interspersed with other lokas. And when people see ghosts, people see aliens, most of the times they are just seeing a vibrational difference. You're just seeing a slightly different vibrational plane. On Shivratri, the vibrational planes are completely... On Shivratri, the vibrational planes are completely loose or free. It becomes the easiest day in the whole year. It becomes easy to shift your consciousness, therefore, on that day. Also, the negative side, it is easier to lose your sanity also. Now, the prescription we all know, you must sit up all night and you must fast and you must basically sit up all night. Now, the reason why we are supposed to sit up all night is also a unique aspect of the human being, because in our culture, we are the only culture in the world where the human being is the most important living thing in the world. We are more important than the gods. Because while the devas are undoubtedly very, very powerful, very, very evolved, everything, they cannot become enlightened, they cannot become liberated. Only the human being can become liberated and enlightened, which is why Mrityuloka, that is our plane of vibration, is the most important zone to come in. And the human being is different from all other animals because the chakras of the human being interact with the world, interact with the environment very differently. All other animals, they are on fours. So the chakras interact on the horizontal plane with the earth and the atmosphere. Some animals, they rise to a 45 degree, chimpanzees and gorillas. So their chakras, but the human being is the only animal where the chakras have come directly into the perpendicular. All the chakras, all the energies flow directly. And so the energy from above does not flow randomly into any chakra, because if you're like this, the energy can enter into any chakra. Whereas if you're up there like that, the energy from above will come from the chakra above the crown and come in. So that is the reason, because today the energy flux is infinite. Today the kind of energy, the Akasha Ganga as they call it, it flows today. The cosmic flow of energy, you know what the Reiki people, pranic people, they all work with it. That is why they say sit up. Sit up the whole night. Sit up the whole night and get it. Sit up the whole night and get it. Because that today is also the day that, this is all going to sound odd, but let it be. Today is the day that Shiva came to the planet to speed up the evolution of the planet. So that is why it is in a sense his birthday. It is the anniversary of the appearance of the consciousness known as Shiva, and the human beings could understand that there is a consciousness known as Shiva and that is speeding up the process. So all the people in yoga, all the people who are doing intense kinds of meditation, pranayama, those people know that today is the most lucky or the most powerful. The other day is Guru Purnima, of course, but Shivaratri is in that sense, because Shiva does not mean a person as such. Shiva means auspicious consciousness. Shiva means the foundation of the universe. Rudram Vishnu, Rudra was what Shiva used to be known as. Rudra is what pervades the universe. Vishnu only means that which pervades, that which is in everything. That is what Vishnu means, not somebody lying on a comfortable waterbed getting his feet massaged. The Vishnu vibration means that there is something that pervades everything. There is something that is a substratum and which is the substance and the support of life. In the Yajurveda, it is very clearly mentioned Rudram Vishnu. Rudra is that support, Rudra is that consciousness. So today that Vishnu aspect or the consciousness aspect of Shiva, it is the easiest of all times to access. It doesn't matter whether you're a raw beginner or you're a very, very advanced meditator. Today is the time that it is easiest to access. That is the importance of Shivaratri. Quite apart from all that, it is a thing to do as a community. Everybody sings bhajan kirtans, all that is fine, but you know, fundamentally you move by yourself. Because you're working with your consciousness. To know Shiva means to know the ultimate consciousness. Because Shiva is not a person as such. Yes, there are forms, what are known as rupas. The consciousness can assume certain forms, it can assume certain limited aspects of manifestation. A rupa is always limited. To manifest means that you have to put boundaries, that you have to put certain limitations. So that is one of the best rupas. But still it is known that it is the last rupa. After that it becomes formless. Which is why when you go to Chidambaram, they always tell you, secret of Chidambaram, Chidambara Rahasya. It is not the dancing Nataraja, it is the blank wall. So this is the last form, or this is the last aspect of limitation. After that, consciousness breaks the boundaries. So today is the day where consciousness can break the boundaries. We can seize our identification with our human body. We can seize our identification with our personality, with all the things that we think are so vital to us, but which are all creations of accident. Our gender, we had no choice in the matter. Where we would be born in the world, what level of affluence, what level of education, what lovely or horrible name. None of these, we had any choice in the matter. To such an extent, we are a conglomeration of accidents or disasters or good fortunes. But there is something deeper than that. There is something deeper than all these chance aggregations. What is that deeper aspect of the self? And today is the day where you can find that. What is the truth about you? Other than your gender, other than your education, other than what you have been, what you have learned, what you wear, what you drive, where you live. All these things can be taken away in an instant. But there is something that endures. There is something which is Shiva. And today is the day when you can find to that.